Students, good morning. Today we are going to start the chapter number 14. Okay, in standard 4 English medium subject English. So today we are going to start the chapter number 14, and the chapter number 14 is very beautiful poem. Okay, the name of the poem is the Violet. So dear students, what is the name of the poem? The Violet. So this is a very beautiful poem written by Jane Taylor. What is the name of the poem? Jane Taylor. Okay, and what is the spelling of Jane Taylor? J-A-N-E, Jane T-A-Y L-O-R, Taylor. Jane Taylor is written the poem The Violet. The Violet. So first you think in your mind, what is the meaning of the violet? You know the meaning of the violet is the name of the color. Violet means the purple color. Okay, so it's called violet. Violet is the name of the color. But you know the second meaning of the violet? You know that? No. So I explain to you. The second meaning of the violet is a small plant. Okay, a small plant with a white or purple flowers, and that flowers with a sweet smell, and that smell appears in a spring. It's called violet. So what is the spell meaning of violet? Violet means a small plant with a white and purple flowers, and the smell of the flower is very sweet, and that smell is appears in the spring. It's called violet. So in the poem, the poet described the meaning of the violet is that, what is the meaning? A small plant with white or purple flowers with a sweet smell, and that smell appears in spring. It's called violet. So I hope you understand the meanings of the violet. So let's start the poem. First I sing the poem, then after I explain the poem to you. So let's study. Down in a green and sandy bed, many subscribing words. So let's show the subscribing words. Let's start. First is bad hand. Okay. So what is the spelling of bad? B A D bad. And what is the spelling of hair? H E A D hair. So bad and hair. This is the rhyming words. Second rhyming word is grew and view. Okay. What is the second rhyming words? Grew and view. So what is the spelling of grew? G R E W. And what is the spelling of view? V I E W. So here in the first para, there is two rhyming words there. First is bad and had. Second is grew and view. So in second para, there is also a two rhyming words there. First is flower and bower. Flower. F L O W E R. Flower. And bower. B O W E R. Flower and bower. Then fair and there. Okay. F A I R. Fair. And T H E R E. There. Fair and there. Then third para, there is no rhyming words there. Okay. Then in the last para also the rhyming words there. Okay. Go and grow. Okay. Go and grow. G O go and G R O W grow. So here in the poem, how many rhyming words are there? One, two, three, four, and five. So in the poem, the violet, there are five rhyming words in the poem. Okay, let's revise the rhyming words. Bad, had, grew, you, flower, bore, pear, that, then go and grow. Now let's start to explain the poem. Down in a green and shady bed. Shady bed. Down in a green. Okay. So you know that the trees, and under the trees there is a shade there. Okay. Under the trees there is a shade there. So we can take the rest under the tree, because the trees has many leaves. Okay, trees has many leaves, and so the under the tree the shade, there is a shade there. So down in a green and shady bed, it's called shady bed. Okay, under the trees the tree shadow is there. So it's called shady bed. A modest violet grew. Okay, under the trees and down in a green. Oops. Under the tree, the all side is green. Okay, because the grass grow there. So it's called the green shady bed. And a modest violet grew. Modest. It models quality of the plant is being humble, and that is not thinking that you are better than other people. It's called humility. So here in the poet, the violet poet, said about the beautiful white and purple flowers. The small plant grew under the branches of a tree. It's called sliding back. But the plant stem was thin, so it was bent and hiding from view. Then after the flowers was grew on the plant, and the flowers looks like very fair and bright, and it might have happy and satisfied instead of hiding there. And there was very happy and satisfied, and also blue means produce flowers was very happy and satisfied. And it was arranged with faint shade of color, and then it was there was a smell of the flower is very sweet smell, and this smell is spread in whole atmosphere and whole silent shade in a green side, and it was smell like a perfume. So the queen wants to grow into the very that plant, and queen wants this pretty flower to see, and he may also learn to grow about the plant and in sweet humility. So here your poem is over. Now let's start the glossary of the poem. Modest, modest, modest means shy, shy, shy. Stock, stalk, stock means a thin stem, stock means a thin stem. Grace, graced, grace means made more attractive. Grace means made more attractive. Bower, B-O-W-E-R. Bower means a pleasant place under the branches of a tree. A pleasant place under the branches of a tree. It's called bower. Content, C-O-N-T-E-N-T. Content means happy and satisfied. Content means happy and satisfied. Bloom, B-L-O-O-M. Bloom. Bloom means produce flowers. Bloom means produce flowers. Tints, T-I-N-T-S. Tints means faint shade of color. What is the meaning of tints? Faint shades of color. It's called tints. Arrow, A-R-R-A-Y. Red means orange. A-R-R-A-N-G-E-D. Orange. Diffuse, D-I-F-F-U-S-E-D. Diffuse means spread widely. Diffuse means spread widely. Humility, H-U-M-I-L-I-T-Y. Humility means the quality of being humble. That is not thinking that you are better than other people. It's called humility. Violet, V-I-O-L-E-T. Violet means a small plant with white or purple flowers with a sweet smell that appears in spring. It's called violet. Once again, modest sign. Stalk, a thin stem. Grace. branches of a tree. Content: happy and satisfied. Bloom: produce flowers. Paints: paint shade of colors. Red: orange. Diffuse: spray widely. Humility: the quality of being humble, that is, not thinking that you are better than other people. Violet: a small plant with white or purple flowers with a sweet smell that appears in spring. So dear friends, here your poem chapter number 14, the Violet, is over. This is very beautiful poems about the white and purple flowers with a good smell, and that smell appears in spring, and poets like the smell of the flowers. And this poem is written by Jane Taylor. So now your poem is over. I hope you understand the poem very well, and you practice seeing also the exercise of the poem at your home. Okay, thank you.